Hello, Cos. What are you doing here? I didn't think anyone knew about this place. Except us Jars. Ah! Are you going to be the new potentate? Gosh! Truly! That's wonderful news. It's not easy being potentate, though. I know. Show me your hands. It's just a little test, Cos. To see if you've got the right stuff. Your skin isn't so smooth, is it? You need slick, slidey hands to be potentate, you know? I'm sorry, Cos. But I don't think you've got what it takes. What a shame. Don't look so glum, Cos. We can still chat. Potentate or not, come back and visit me. When you can. Don't look so glum. We can still come back and visit.
Again, Cos. I'm happy you came back.
I have good tidings for you, Cos. Have you noticed the rare flowers growing in this village? I asked the villagers if you could pick some of them, and they said you'd be very welcome. Go on, Cos.
Who knows?
Say, cuz, have you met Uncle Alexander? He used to live here with us, but then he left to be a champion. I asked to go with him, but he said, the path of champions must be trod alone. So heroic, right? I miss him, though. If you see him, you should ask him to teach you how to fight, cuz. He's big and tough and strong. Uncle Alexander said he won't be back again.
My home is of the past, and the past, as they say, is a different country.
I suppose that's part of being a warrior, isn't it? So, please don't tell anyone, cuz. But I'm actually a warrior Jar as well. One day, I'll be just like Uncle Alexander, and I'll have to leave the village to become a champion. Uncle Alexander won't come back here again.
My home is of the past, and the past...
I suppose that's...
You finally come. Blythe told me everything. You've defeated General Radahn, unlocking the stars. The general was blighted by scarlet rot and driven to madness. But not long ago, he was hailed as the mightiest demigod of them all. There is no parallel to your achievement. to Lady Rani's acute judgment of character. Thanks to you, Lady Rani's fate once again stirs, and the path to Nokron has opened. Descend underground, where the fallen star struck Limgrave, and make it yours. The precious treasure of Nokron. Blythe not to bother waiting for him. Blythe has been given an import, apparently, a matter of great. Wait, descend underground and make it yours so that lady. Something else?
My thanks, friend. I'm going to see Mistress Rani now. I don't know what came over old E.G., but even if the odds are slim, I need to check the mistress is safe. Now, Rani can finally set in motion the fight against her fate she's dreamt of for so long. I'm going to see Mistress Rani. I don't know what, but even if the odds.
as war counselor? I presume you've spoken with Blythe? Very well. There is something you should know. The Two Fingers gave Blythe to Lady Rani as a faithful follower. Her very shadow, incapable of treachery. But if Lady Rani, as an Empyrean, resists being an instrument of the Two Fingers, the shadow will go mad, transforming from a follower into a horrid curse. But such is his destiny. In such matters, Blythe's own thoughts hold no weight. It pains me so. But he must be neutralized. For Lady Rani's sake.
Ah, you. Please, leave me be. It's pathetic, I know, but I need to think. Ah, you. Please, it's pathetic, I know, but...
Journey to the capital, Laendell, to the east of the Altus Plateau, at the foot of the Erd Tree. The Two Fingers will deny your passage no longer. You may be our best hope. Ah, you've already heard. Indeed. It seemed the whelp harbored suspicions, so I had no further use for her. Honestly, what a man to do. A determined plebeian is more wicked than an Ormond horn, quite frankly. I suspect that's just what the Queen wants. A dose of ambition to incite the tarnished.
Ah, you. Please, leave me be. It's pathetic, I know, but I need to think. So you know already, do you? Right. It's true. My father cast me out for indulging my emotions. Forgetting the mission. Punishment for offing his pawns. Lord Gideon has offered me guidance all my life. I would have done anything for him, to place him on the throne of Elden Lord. And yet though it was not my intent, I betrayed him. And I kind of think he'd order his men to enact such tragedy. Where is the justice he purports in that? He once told me that if he became Elden Lord, he would never allow the downtrodden to be. Was he simply lying to me? No, no, no. How could I say that? Father has... And now...
Thank you.
No. No, no. How could his father have him now? Is that ash? I can smell the ancient storm in it. My thanks. I'll gladly take it. I'm not like Roderica. I don't feel the presence of spirits, let alone see them. Still, this ash, it reminds me of my first hawk. Thank you. In this ash, it reminds me of my first...